I'm at the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. We're a pediatric hospital, and we do a lot of diagnostics for kids who were born with a variety of birth defects or who don't quite develop normally. And we're learning that there are many, many, many different ways that your genome can be involved in leading to those problems. Our ability to sequence the human genome has been phenomenal. And around the world, there are many, many efforts to sequence genomes from all sorts of people. Normal people, people of different ethnicities. We're starting to understand what makes us different from each other, what are the things that are always the same. We're able to compare the genomes of healthy people with those of people who have a variety of different types of illnesses. Some are very easy to find, some are harder to find. We're starting to understand the genetic underpinnings for a lot of common diseases like diabetes and cancer and heart disease, things that aren't purely genetic, they're complicated to understand. But we hope that as we learn more and more about the genetics, we know more and more about genetic susceptibility, and the real promise for genetics is, can we look at your genome and then help you to figure out what you might be susceptible to? Only about 1% of your genome, maybe 1 to 2% of your genome, codes for things that are proteins in your body, codes for the structural parts of your body. That's a very small percentage. So those pieces of DNA, we understand what they do. And when we sequence your DNA, what we're doing is we're looking for changes. How does your sequence differ from what we understand to be the normal sequence? So as we go ahead and do that, we can figure out which of those changes might be causing disease. And those are easy, relatively easy to find in the exome, the part of the genome we understand the best. But that leaves us with 98% of the genome that we don't really understand. And we know a lot of its importance, but we don't know which parts of it are important. So we're in at such an exciting time because there's so much that we know, but there's so much that we don't know. So for students who are just thinking about careers in science, the questions are enormous. What is the function of those huge parts of the genome? How might they cause human disease? How can you use them to understand what happens? One of the challenges that we're facing is how to give information to our patients. So, for example, if you are a child with a heart defect and we study your genome and we find that maybe you have a susceptibility to cancer, do the parents want that information about their child? They're dealing with a lot of complex issues. How do we give that information? How do we follow people? How do we make sure they understand it? So aside from just the scientists who are really trying to understand the science behind what do changes in your genome mean, we are also trying to understand how does this help people? How can people use it in their healthcare? How can they avoid anxiety that might come with knowing things they're not ready to do? And we're learning that it's really complicated. So there's actually a whole part of genomics that is actually funded by the National Institutes of Health. It's viewed as very important, called the ELSI section of genetics, which is the ethical, legal, and societal implications of what we do. And that's really considered to be just as important as understanding the science.